Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Minesweeper, a new series I hope to start on the channel where I play Viscera Cleanup and, talk about whatever's on my mind. If you've been following me since the Tengu Drop days, yes indeed, this may sound familiar. It's pretty much the Cleanup cast, only subtle edition. Perfect time for someone to ruin my intro, but as I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted, so it seems, obviously Joe's probably much very busy with real life, probably enjoys not having to, deal with the extra stress of having to produce, YouTube videos on the reg, which is fine. I figured in the meantime, until we can get together and actually record more content, I would do maybe a solo version of the Cleanup cast, because I actually enjoyed, legit enjoyed the playing Viscera Cleanup and just chatting, about whatever. I think back in the day it was more like, I enjoyed doing something with Joe, that we used to do before we started making YouTube videos, which is, just hanging out, playing games and shooting the breeze. I enjoy Viscera Cleanup in general, just because it's very therapeutic to clean, and I don't know, for me, personally, cleaning in real life is a little bit more difficult because, I have like allergies regarding dust and whatnot, so cleaning is like. It's like, I gotta make sure I'm not doing anything else during the day, because either I'm gonna have an allergy attack, or, I'm gonna be, like, held up because I'm stuck on, like, some kind of, med that's probably gonna keep me out of action the rest of the day. Some kind of, like, allergy medicine, because usually when I take an allergy medicine, I can expect to be drowsy the rest of the day. Nonetheless, instead of sounding like a nerd, I guess what I wanted to do with, since it's solo, is, maybe talk about things that I usually can't talk about on the Cleanup cast, and it's not because of any sort of restrictions, but maybe things that, I don't know, just, to be honest, I just really wanted to bring this series back in some form. That was the main goal there, if you will. Are you kidding me? I'm not even online, I'm kicking buckets over. Are you kidding me? Jesus. Yeah, I'm probably gonna get distracted very easily. Cleaning. I don't know. Again, cleaning is... this is a thing. I don't know what it is about cleaning. Cleaning is very therapeutic for me, I guess, in the sense that, you're probably putting things back into places where, things should be. So I think it's a sense of accomplishment of, returning things to where they should be. And then on top of that, cleaning also gives you the opportunity to rearrange what exists and, possibly make it better or different. So, I don't know, maybe subconsciously I enjoy order and sometimes changing the order. I don't know. To not get too psychologically deep here. Man, I chose, like, the wrong time to record this. The first topic that came to mind, something that we never talk about ever on Cleanup Cast, is food. And it's not because, again, any restrictions. It's just, usually the times that we record, talking about food would be a bad idea because none of us can eat at that time, or it would be a bad time to eat at that time. But I'm recording this before lunch, so I thought it would be a perfect time to talk about food. The only downside, really, is that I'm not very adventurous when it comes to food. Like, I have the worst picky eater, the palate, I guess is what you would call it, ever. But it's not by choice, really. Like, I want to be an adventurous eater, but for some reason my body just refuses to accept certain tastes. So, like, I have a very boring palate by default, I guess. My general palate for taste is very bland. Like, too much flavor is really a turnoff for my taste buds, which is pretty sad. I also have a lot of food allergies, a lot of seafood allergies, if you will, which sucks because that eliminates a ton of potential food, And that's also sad because one thing I really enjoy is the presentation of food. That's probably one of my favorite things about Japanese food in particular is Japanese people seem to take a lot of pride. What the hell? Oh. Take a lot of pride in the way that their food is presented. Like, I remember watching a documentary about children who are taught, at early ages to take pride in their home lunches. So, they wake up early, they make their lunches, but it's much more than just making their lunches, teaching their children that responsibility. They also teach them to, take some pride in the way that your food is presented. And I guess that's something that it's a tradition that's carried over throughout their generations, And it's really interesting because you don't really see that much in I guess Western culture. You'll see that in marketing, a burger from McDonald's looks great in the ad, but when you get it, it's really slapped together haphazardly if you're lucky at that, I've gotten burgers that are just wrongly assembled, the bun is upside down, no joke. So it's interesting to see cultures that really take pride in the way that their food looks, and as a result it always looks delicious, but it's usually food I can never eat either because I'm allergic or my taste buds are just nope, you're not enjoying that, which sucks. There's also just not very many good eateries, places to dine around where I live. This is really because I live in a bad neighborhood, so it's just why would you spend any time or money investing in, tasty establishments that aren't, probably not up to par with health codes, if we're being honest, the chances that someone is sweating in your burgers, probably pretty high here, when it's just something you accept because, where else are you gonna eat? Really, at the end of the day, you're getting sort of the, you get what you pay for, cheap burgers, and you get a little side of sweat. It's probably disgusting to talk about, but it's probably true. It's probably true even in more established places like McDonald's. I'm sure you're getting sweat in there as well. I think I read a thing where, if you're buying cheap meat, you're probably eating poop. I think you're probably eating poop regardless, whenever you're getting meat, you're probably getting a little poop in there regardless, no matter how clean you get it. I guess a little bit of poop never hurt nobody. I mean, we've evolved over the years, I'm sure, assuming you believe in evolution. But, we've survived, I'm sure, eating far worse versions of meat. Granted, we lived far less longer in those days, but, you live and you learn, and then you get better, and you don't eat the bad things. I guess I actually do have an interesting way that we can turn this conversation, if this is even a conversation. I should make this a two-sided thing. So, hey, if you guys are picky eaters, not by choice, would love to know that I'm not alone. Regardless, love to know your favorite foods. But let's turn this on its head and let's talk about, a less than savory topic in terms of food, I guess, is because this is, I don't know, maybe I'm just weird and I'm the only one who thinks about this, but I've always wondered just how desperate I would need to be in order to actually consider eating human flesh, say you get stuck, stranded on in a deserted island, your friend, or maybe not even your friend. Let's not even make it personal. What was that? Okay. Let's just say you washed up ashore on a deserted island with just some stranger, and that stranger died of natural causes. Let's just assume you didn't murder them, over a can of Coke or something. But you decide, okay, there's a body. It's currently perfectly preserved. You can't eat fish because you're allergic, that's out of the picture. You can't eat a crab. Which, by the way, I'm going all over the place here, but when I was a kid, used to love shrimp. Tried to eat shrimp, discovered tried to eat shrimp as an adult, that is, after many years of not eating shrimp for whatever reason. Ate shrimp, immediately had an allergic effect. I'm like, why? I used to eat shrimp as a kid, used to love shrimp as a kid, can no longer eat shrimp. So frustrating. So frustrating. Which, by the way, is going off on a tangent here. I swear, like, it's interesting how people get disgusted at eating bugs, but yet we eat sea bugs and it's perfectly fine, you know? I'm just saying, there seems to be a disconnect sometimes where people don't accept that crabs, crabs and lobsters are pretty much just sea bugs, you know? You scale them up to the sizes, or you scale them down if you want to the sizes of bugs, and they're pretty much bugs. Nonetheless, as I was saying, assuming, you know, maybe you can find a coconut on this deserted island, maybe you'll find an animal or two, but good luck hunting it if you don't have the skills. But I mean, you know, you've got a huge chunk of human there. Like, I wonder how desperate would I need to be, or would I even entertain the fact of eating a human corpse? Or human flesh, excuse me, let's not go overboard here. Maybe you just need a few chunks, you know, of that flesh. But nonetheless, how desperate would I need to be, and how much would I, in fact, eat? You know, I honestly couldn't give you an answer. I guess if I had enough that was worth, you know, living with myself over, you know, assuming I had like a wife, a child, maybe waiting for me, and I was like, yeah, okay, I have to wait like 3 days. Someone will get me. In the meantime, I might have to poke at this dead person, you know, not poke at them, but, you know, nibble on their bits a bit. Then, you know, maybe I'll, under consideration. I'm pretty sure you don't get any nutrients that you need from eating human. I think that's a thing, like eating your own kind, like cannibalism is not an effective way to get any of your necessary nutrients and the things that keep you healthy. But I'm assuming it still does count as food that would, or you know, whatever is required to keep you alive. I don't know the specifics here, but okay, let's just make this even more morbid. So let's just say that you accept eating human flesh. You're like, okay, you know what? I have something to live for. I'm gonna eat this flesh, and hopefully that'll keep me going long enough. How do you present it? How do you prepare it, if you will? How do you take it? I feel like eating raw human flesh is just, you know, that's just silly. Why can't I grab these things again? Get off the thing so I can grab you. There we go. I don't know what these are. Tape recorders or names. Probably people who've eaten human flesh. But yeah, as I was saying, how would you prepare a human feast? Assuming, okay, I'm just making it sound weird. How would you prepare the bit of human you would need to eat in order to survive, you know? Because I feel like eating it raw is just terrible. Like, I feel like presentation would go a long way in helping you ease the fact that you're eating a human. I feel like, you know, like if you cook it up, I'm sure you would want to cook it up anyway, because you don't usually eat meat raw anyway, so that would be a dumb idea. I feel like cooking it up would be easier to go down, because, you know, you're like, oh, you can pretend it's a piece of steak, or, you know, it's chicken. I don't know what human flesh looks like cooked, you know? But I assume it would look like, you know, beef, or something similar to beef. A steak? I don't know. But I feel like cooking it would be a lot better than eating it raw. But then you have to go through the whole process of cutting the piece of flesh, and then cooking the piece of flesh, or preparing the piece of flesh. I feel like maybe that's a little bit more traumatizing to the mental fortitude. I don't know. Like, I think about a lot of weird things when I'm alone. When you have a lot of, when I'm rendering videos, sometimes I don't know. That's not even true. I usually occupy my time when I'm rendering videos, but nonetheless, sometimes when you don't have much else to do, especially when you're at a job that's just, you know, mind-numbingly tedious, sometimes you have to entertain yourself with, I guess, cannibalism. I don't know. I don't think about cannibalism very often, but I figure, you know, I should take it to a weird place if I'm going to take this conversation anywhere, and cannibalism would be a good idea. Especially, you know, we're in Viscera Cleanup. Like, what if you're stuck in this facility? And you're like, oh, there's human flesh here. And, you know, over the weekend, or it is a weekend, but, you know, the only way I'm going to be able to survive the weekend is to nibble on some of this here human flesh. You know, would you do it? I guess so. You know, maybe. If there's nothing else to eat, are you gonna drink the cleaners? I don't think so. It's gonna just immediately kill you. I guess what I'm trying to say is, cannibalism is okay under circumstances? No? I don't know. I really don't know where I'm going. There's no moral there. But I guess, you know, hey, if you were stuck, oh god. We're gonna learn a lot about each other, I guess, through this series. If you were deserted on an island, stuck in a facility, would you eat a human at any point, or would you just, you know, say, screw it, I'm gonna starve to death? And I don't think you could eat yourself, because that would be redundant. Yeah, that would be redundant. Eat your arm and somehow avoid, you know, the blood loss. I don't think that would work. You probably don't get any nutrients from eating yourself, right? So, you're going in some weird directions today. I guess when you're cleaning up, this sort of gonna come to pass. You'll get some weird thoughts going on. I don't know if there's any actual regular discussions I can have regarding food. I'll be honest, man. Sometimes I hate having to eat. You know, when you're like working on something, you're like, damn it, I'm getting hungry. I'm gonna have to waste time making something, or, you know, just generally eating. Sometimes eating, I feel like I wish I could just, you know, it's gonna sound weird, but you know, like the future where there's like pills. You know, you get entire food in pills. Sometimes I feel like that would be grand, you know. Working hard on something, and I don't want to stop. Just eat a pill, get a nice steak dinner. Well, let's not go back immediately to steak, but you know what I'm saying. You know, a nice meal. So I'm like, or you know, like the Willy Wonka with the whole dessert and a gum. That'd be great. Or no, it was a full meal in gum, and the dessert is where it went wrong. But you know what I'm saying. That would be great. A full four course meal just in gum form. It would save so much time. We would be so much more efficient. Sound like a corporate overlord here over here. Just, yes, you just down this horribly inefficient piece of gum, and you get back to work. Damn it! No lunchtime for you. That's always been a terrible thing that for every employer I've ever had is my lunch breaks. I don't spend a lot of time eating, so lunch breaks are anytime I can, I try to take the minimum amount of lunch break time necessary, which has led to me getting into trouble on multiple occasions where they're like, hey, can't do that. You gotta take your full lunch break. I'm like, man, I'm done. What else am I gonna do? You know, what else do I do on my lunch break? I could read a book, but that would be awkward. Me the only one reading a book amongst other people still eating very slowly and probably enjoying their food. Where I'm just like, you know, if it was up to me, just get back to work right now. What else am I gonna do? I don't want to read a book at work. I think that's the thing. Guess I could bring a game of some sort, but what? I don't really have any handouts. I can bring a Game Boy. I'm gonna risk bringing my Game Boy to work. Possibly have someone steal it. I mean, you know, not that they probably would, but you don't know. You don't know, man. You can't keep your eyes on your Game Boy unless you keep them in your pockets. But you can't always be working in a place where you can just keep a Game Boy in your pocket. This foolish thinking. You could keep it on your phone, but A, my phone sucks because it's busted, doesn't work right. And B, it's kind of like, you know, games on the phone, from what I can tell, it sucks your battery life so quickly. It's just like, well, that's fun. I can play, like, I don't know, what are the kids playing these days? I wanted to say Flappy Bird, but I realized just how out of date that was. Let's just say Flappy Pig. Let's say Flappy Pig was the next big thing. Flappy Pig, you know, you're playing Flappy Pig for like 5 minutes. You're like, oh, whoa, there goes like 50% of my battery. Hope no one has to call me the rest of the day. And again, maybe that's just my phone's broken, so it takes 50% of damn battery just to play Flappy Pig. But feels like an inefficient use of your phone. Especially if you're gonna need it in the end of the day, you know? You never know. You might see Superman. Pull out your camera, try to take a picture of Superman. Oh, your battery's low, can't get a picture of Superman. Shouldn't have played Flappy Pig for 10 minutes. Wasted all my battery space. I don't know how we got to this point. Talked about food, cannibalism, now Flappy Pig, Superman. I guess this is what it's come to. Honestly, it just gives you insight into the weird side of my brain sometimes. To be honest, 99% of the time, think about regular things, you know, music, TV shows. And there's always those 1% bits where you're like, you entertain a very weird idea. Oh God, there's blood on the ceiling. It's like a Lionel Richie song, the most gorgeous version of a Lionel Richie song. Bleeding on the ceiling. Yeah. Nobody really knows that there was a zombie Lionel Richie at one point. It bleeding on the ceiling. That was a joke. Should've brought a bucket. Yep, should've brought a bucket. Damn it. Back down. Go down. 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 I broke it. Something's gotta give. Either you gotta go down. Okay. There we go. Oh, these damn buckets. We need bigger buckets so that I can store more gore and gross liquids in them. So yeah, I think in the future, maybe I'll take the suggestions from you guys as to topics I should discuss. I liked the jive we were getting with recent episodes of the Cleanup Cast on Tangy Drop, where... Nope, gonna get ejected. Oh! Lovely. Where we would, talk about very niche things that would spark some very interesting discussions in the comment section. So, I don't know. I'm open to a lot of topics. Clearly, I spend a lot of time looking up and thinking about weird things. So, really, the topic of oddities in discussion, not very lost on me. God, this thing jams so much. You think it's a teenager in a band in their garage? That funny joke, you know, because jam, or maybe it jams so much I could put it on a bread with some peanut butter. You have to come back with the gun to get all these bullet holes. Lovely. But yeah, in the same vein, while I'm on the subject of Cleanup Cast, same vein, I want to try and 100% these levels. So probably start with the smaller ones and get to the bigger ones as we go. And we'll see just how far I can get before I lose my mind or completely stop thinking of topics to discuss, and or things get so weird that everybody stops watching. Maybe people got too weirded out by the cannibalism talk earlier, and I'm just talking to nobody right now. That's fine. I'm talking to nobody right now. I'm talking to myself. It's okay, Keaton. I'm here to listen. Thank you. I am probably going to try and keep these a lot shorter than the Cleanup Cast as well. It's probably going to work better that way, for one. Two, you know, you can only handle so much weird discussion anyway. Before you gotta tap out. I know even the strongest will tap out at some point, but I think it'll work better as a much shorter form, but longer than usual form content on the channel. Don't know how often I'll do it. again, obviously, if it picks up steam, if people really enjoy seeing it and want to see it more often, I'll do it more often. If not, I'll do it every once in a while. It's a nice change of pace, really, for me. Spending a lot of time doing a whole bunch of stuff for the channel. Sometimes it's just nice to, you know, sit back a bit, think about some weird things while you clean up a whole bunch of gore. You know, the same old, the American dream, really. In a way, I'm sure someone out there, their American dream is to clean up gore and shoot the breeze with anybody who will listen. I guess doesn't have to be friends, doesn't have to be strangers, just be the general public. I guess it's the equivalent of me walking around the streets, talking to myself, talking about the end of the world. You know, maybe with a megaphone, in hand, and you know. Probably haven't showered in days, but you know, I'm like, the end is nigh. Or maybe just that crazy person you see in the bus talking to themselves, pretty much doing the same thing, except I'm at home and I'm recording a video. We're not so different, you and I. Have we reached that weird point yet? I feel like we're reaching that weird point. I'm sure. I mean, I'll pin down some topics for next time, if there is a next time, and I'll make sure that it's not as awkward and I'm not talking about cannibalism. I don't know. Another reason I cut a lot of stuff is because not everything I always talk about lands, and it's good in editing because you can cut that stuff out. You know, cut out the fat, cut out the weirdness. You get a better idea, or you get a better final product. God, I didn't even touch that. Okay, you get a final product at the end of it. You know, you think, hey, Keaton's an okay person. Then you watch something like this, and you're like, okay, Keaton is a little weirder than I thought. You know what? At the end of the day, aren't we all a little weird? Yeah. Let's burn the boombox. No music tunes for us. Not here. Just us and our thoughts. No entertainment. I've actually done quite a bit here. Got this whole wing area all cleaned out. Sweet. You know what? Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna leave it there. I think we've established the awkward weirdness enough, at least enough for one episode. Well, we'll pick this up again, hopefully, maybe, if you guys enjoyed it. If you guys did enjoy it, please be sure to let me know. Leave a like. If you aren't already subscribed and you want to see more of this awkward conversation in the future, be sure to subscribe. There's also a lot of other great content on the channel. I apologize if this is like the first thing you're watching. It's not the most proper reflection of my channel, but you know, thanks for watching nonetheless. As you put a single person in a room, tell them to clean up gore, and left with their own devices and their own thoughts, things start to get a little too weird, you know? If that scroll was active, it would probably say like, hey, you know, Keaton should probably just stop talking right now and stop being weird. So let's wrap that weirdness up right now. So thank you so much for watching, and hopefully I'll see you guys next time.